Bodega and doing research is really ruled by the high tide and the low tide cycles. So in low tide, I'm waking up at like 4 a.m., 5 a.m. to drive out to the field. I am a fourth year environmental science major, and here at Bodega, I'm studying seagrass wasting disease on our eelgrass in Bodega Bay and Tomales Bay. Before Bodega, I had never done any kind of marine ecology. I've never taken a class or anything like that. I was really excited because I've grown up by the coast. I've always loved the ocean. So getting to work in my favorite ecosystem was really exciting.
UC Davis has a big emphasis on undergraduate research, and the hole that we're trying to fill here is the gap between students helping out in a lab and students actually being able to conduct their own research program.
So I'm collecting third rank blades. You can kind of see this is the last one. This is four, and it alternates 3, 2, 1. I want to get this one. This one has, it's kind of, you can see the disease a little bit right there. I want to know if a disease lesion along the middle is completely cutting off access to the rest of the leaf. So we'll see when I go in the dark room and see how active the photosystems are for photosynthesis.
The Bodega Marine Lab is a really fantastic place for students to become literally immersed in research. They're able to do field research, and they're able to be immersed in a community of researchers out there that are interacting with each other and teaching each other about how to solve problems related to our coastal marine ecosystems.
Broadly, my research this summer is focused on a newly identified species of non-indigenous anemone. I'm really interested in how their reproduction works across their range. And then I'm also interested in how they're interacting with the native species of anemone here. A lot of the times when you're working in a lab on campus, you're doing what other people need you to do, and you're often like a lab tech or research assistant. Here, you are the researcher, and I think that's really valuable. At the tanks, I have two experiments going on. The first experiment is a growth experiment. So I have a bunch of eelgrass plants and I'm seeing how they grow as I manipulate them. I basically just want to see how the disease impacts growth. And then my second experiment is with the little eelgrass sea hares or phylloplasia. She'll be on both of these leaves, and if there's disease on here, it might vector between the two. We're hoping that it doesn't because they're really cute and we don't want that to happen. Definitely going through a lot of trial and error. I don't even know if the stuff I'm collecting right now is gonna work. Right now I have some data, but I still have to do a lot of analyzing.
Research can be a really frustrating process, and I think that's really important for our students to know, and it's important for our faculty to be mentoring the students to tell them that, you know what, that's normal. That's how research works. Like, it's almost never gonna work the first time you try it.
The community has been incredibly essential to me in continuing to persist through different challenges. It's really nice to be able to like go back to our dorms at night. We're sitting around the kitchen table and we're all like, oh, well, my thing didn't work today. And then somebody else is like, well, my thing didn't really work out either. So I think it's really good encouragement to keep ourselves going. I've gotten really close with the eelgrass, and like I understand their growth at like a really minute level because I've had that trial and error. And having results not work out the way that you want them to, it just forces you to come up with different hypotheses and keep testing things. The whole process is just a really valuable learning experience.
I might move to a different spot.
Because if one spot doesn't work, you gotta do another one.